glory, we worship you. Oh Lord, we worship you. You are worthy to. We give you all the glory, we give all the glory. Give him the glory this morning. We worship you, my Lord. You, he's worthy, he's worthy. Give him all the glory. We give you all the glory. We worship you. We worship you, my Lord. You, he's worthy to praise him. Give him all. You, my Lord, you are worthy to sing. You are Alpha, you are Alpha, Alpha and Omega. We worship you, we worship you, my Lord. You are worthy. Is he worthy this morning? Sing, you are Alpha, you are Alpha, Alpha and Omega. We worship you, we worship you. You are worthy, so give him all the glory. We give you all the glory. Worship you, my Lord. You are worthy. We give you all the glory, all the glory. Yeah, we worship you, my Lord. You are worthy.
Caponda to come and open in a word of prayer. As Johnson, you can come down.
Tinamata. Babu wedi muri musoro kudenga. Ndikutenda zvakarongwa zvinodzimangwa nani. Ishe wangu tinotenda tauya panzvimbo cheya tinofanira kunge tiri. Patinonzwa kunyaradzwa. Ishe wangu takamirira kunzwa kwenyu kwechipiri. Sangana nations, no pictures like a senna, and a Shamakan Katmo Penny Uno, Katmetsim, with him Katmabas, Shamakanaka, also waiting for thy second coming. And Lord Jesus, we are not expecting, Lord, to hear from you, to comfort us, encourage us, fill us, Lord, the power of the Holy Spirit, and Lord, also to encourage us, Lord Jesus, so that whenever we went through different temptations, oh my Father, you'll be always with us, because we promise that I shall be with you, even in you, up to the end of the world. When things are good, you are with us. When things are bad, you are with us. And Lord Jesus, if there are some sick and afflicted, Lord, among us this morning, and we might be going through different situations, and Lord, you are the all-seeing eye. You know everything. May you just comfort each and everyone, so that you will witness, Lord, after the service, that Lord Jesus Christ, thou have answered every question, Lord, this morning, after the preaching of the word. And Lord, as we are now entering, Lord, in the song service, you are worthy to be given all praise and honor. If there is somebody to be given all that praise, it is you, Lord, this morning. Even when you were still here on earth, oh my Father, wherever you were, there was a lot of noise which showed that people were alive, were seeing something, Lord, in their lives. And Lord, you are still the same yesterday and forever. May you come again and do the same And not forgetting, Lord, the preaching of the word, may you also, Lord, inspire our precious pastor, that Lord Jesus Christ, you will speak, Lord, under your inspiration. Until, Lord, we would say, did not our hearts burn as it is speaking, Lord, unto us. We commit ourselves before thee in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Let's just praise the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Come on, you can do better than that. Let's just give the Lord a hand of praise this morning. Aren't you thankful for something this morning?
Amen. I would like to wish Sister Naomi a happy birthday. Let's just give the Lord praise for that. Happy birthday, Sister Naomi. Amen. Hallelujah. So good to see God keeping us this far. Just turn around, bless somebody, say God bless you, and welcome in the house of the Lord. And ask them, are you happy? Tell them, if you're not happy, I'm moving away from you. Amen.
Noma indlela inameva sizothandaza. Sithi noma indlela inameva sizothandaza. Sithi noma indlela inameva sizothandaza. Noma indlela inameva sizothandaza. Sithi noma 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 indlela inameva sizothanda. Sithi noma noma sizothandaza. Sizothandaza sizothanda. Sizothandaza sizothandaza. Sizothandaza. Sithi noma noma sizothandaza. Sithi noma noma hoye sizotha. Sizothandaza sizotha. Sizothandaza sizothandaza sizotha. Sizothandaza insona then said hithi nyangwe ziwome ziwome sithi nona hithi nyangwe ziwome sinona matha sinona matha sinona. It doesn't matter what you're facing this morning. Chingona matha. Oh, chingona matha, na matha, chingona matha, chingona matha, chingona matha. Sithi noma noma, oh, sizothandaza. Sithi noma noma. Oh, sizothandaza, 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 sizothandaza. I just want us to put our hands together and dance to the Lord. It doesn't matter what you're going through this morning, you just go on your knees and pray. Oh, 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 sizothandaza, 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 sizothandaza. Sizotha, can I hear the brothers only? Sizotha ndaza, tandaza. Sizotha ndaza, sizotha ndaza. Now the sisters, sizotha ndaza, tandaza.
sizothanda sa sizothanda. Come on everybody. Oh, sizothanda sa. Sizothanda sa. Sithi sizothanda sa. Thanda sa. Thanda sa. Sizothanda sa. Sizothanda sa. How many are saying prayer is my weapon? Just turn around once more. Bless somebody. Amen. Goodbye world. I'll stay no longer with you. Goodbye pleasures of sin. I'll stay no longer with you. I have made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. I have made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. Say goodbye world. Well, I'll stay no longer with you. Goodbye pleasures of sin. I'll stay no longer with you. Said I made up to go the rest of my life. Well, I have made up my mind to go God's way. Say goodbye world. Well, I'll stay no longer with you. And goodbye pleasure. God has done so much for me. Well, I have made up my mind to go God's way the rest of my life. Said I have made up my mind to go God's way. Oh, you say I've got my mind made up, say, and I want. Well, because I want to see my Jesus someday. Just sing it with all your heart. Sing, I've got my mind. I've got my mind. I am saved by the Holy Ghost. Jesus brought my life. Oh, someday. Sing, I've got my will. And I won't. Say, because I want to see my Jesus someday. There's a part you say, oh, all I want to see him, just to look upon his face.
that to see forevermore of His saving grace. Where along the streets of glory, let me lift my voice, singing cares of past, home at last. Let's just sing one more time. Say all I want, say all I want to see Him, just to look upon His face. Well, there to sing forevermore of His saving grace. Oh, on the streets of glory, let me lift my voice, sing cares of past. Sing, I've got my mind made up. Well, and I want, well, because I want. I want to see my Jesus. If I've got people who are saved in the house, can I get a shout for the Lord? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. We may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah is the highest praise. Amen. That's wonderful. Amen. As the ushers collect the tithes and offerings, we're going to have our specials. But before the corner plans and specials, we have a visitors here. We have a friend of us in our midst, Michelle from Highfield. God bless you, Michelle. Where are you? Just raise your hand wherever you are. So that just, oh, there she is. God bless you, Sister Michelle. We welcome you in our midst. Amen. We also have a visitor amongst us, Sister Shalom. This is from Sister, I don't know if it's Nico or Nigel. Sister Shalom, where are you? Oh, there she is. Amen. Let's just receive you with a round of applause. Amen. God bless you so much. We're going to have Brother Kapunda to give us a song. Then I'm not sure Brother Shepherd who's coming to sing, but someone from the Fokolani family is coming to give a song. Amen. So Brother Kapunda, then Brother Shepherd. Tinguba pachi poche maoko. Amen.
I greet you all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. If you are all happy this morning, and I'm happy to see my friend Marco there, I'm free to tell him that he worries me most of the time, but he knows the story. Touch down what Mungo to Sungu came, Bishan. Amen. So, my Sungi Castere, no. Just feel free. The song that I want to sing this morning is quite one of the old songs, but it's kind of prophetic song. To touch everybody, depends on what you are going through. Amen. We'll talk it over.
Those shadows deepen and my heart bleeds. I will not question the way He leads. This side of heaven, we know in part. I will not question a broken heart. I'll trust His leading, He'll never fail. You'll be my refuge when storms assail. And though He try me, I'll know You'll find that all my burdens are silver lined. We'll talk it over in the by and by. We'll talk it over, my Lord and I. I'll the reason. He'll tell me why when we talk it over in the by and by. When we talk it over in the by and by. We'll talk it when we talk it over in the by and by. Those shadows deepen and my heart bleed. I will not question the way he leads. This side of heaven we know in part. I will not question a broken heart. We'll talk it over in the by and by. We'll talk it over, my Lord and I. I'll ask the reason, you'll tell me why. When we talk it over in the by and by.
Let's just give it one more time for Brother Kaponda. Amen. Surely we're going somewhere. How many believe it? Amen. Let's just give it up for the little girl. Come on, somebody, just give her some round of applause. Amen. Like mother, like father. Wonderful. Hallelujah. Such a powerful song and a message. Amen. As our brother prays for the tithes and offerings.
Let's bow our heads and pray. Eternal Lord, Jesus Christ, this morning, according to the song, only believe all things are possible. We humbly come under your blood to present these tithes and offerings. Fulfill your word. Blessed be thy name, Lord, as we commit all thine holiness under your blood. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Amen. God bless you. To all singers, Baraka Ponda, may God bless you. Amen. Let's just rise to our feet. Amen. There was a time when the disciples asked Jesus, said, Father, teach us how to pray. There's a prayer which Jesus taught the disciples, and it's a prayer that has stayed with us all the way, and it's a prayer that we can still make this morning. Amen. Whatever you're believing for this morning, just join in the song. Amen.
Hear our prayer. Oh Lord, we are your children, and we've gathered here today. We have gathered. cry. Oh Lord, we need your mercy and we need your grace today. Oh, hear us as we pray. Sing our Father. May your glory fill the earth. As the waters come, sing, see our hearts. Lord, and remove anything that is standing.
Raise up your hand. Amen. Already have a prayer request from one of our sisters. So if you have a request, just raise up your hand to the Lord this morning. Heavenly Father, we thankful to you once again this morning. Lord, for the privilege and the honor to be in the house of the Lord, to be gathered before you this wonderful Sunday morning. Dear Lord, as we now in your presence, we ask for your mercy and we ask for your grace, dear Lord, to be upon each and every one of us. I pray that the Holy Spirit will move across this place today, Lord, from bench to bench, from heart to heart, Lord, revealing yourself as each one has need of you this morning. Dear Lord, whatever the need might be, It could be physical. It could be something that has gone wrong with the body. It could be material. Whatever the case may be, Lord God Almighty, and more so our spiritual need, dear Lord, we pray that you will minister to each and every need on every level. Just reach out and bless your dear children, Lord. Father God, even the request that, Lord, our dear sister brought up to me just a couple of moments ago, I pray that, Lord, you'll just grant her heart's desire and just bless her. In the mighty name of Jesus, make a way for her such as she desires this morning, Lord. In the mighty name of the Lord Jesus, bless the word this morning as it goes forth. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Amen. You may take your seat for a moment. Greetings to you all in the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen. We're thankful this morning to be gathered together in the house of the Lord. Amen. Thank you for the wonderful songs. Amen. It was so good to see that little girl sing that song. Amen. Hallelujah. Like she's saying, what's the matter with you grown-ups? Only believe. All things are possible. Amen. Praise the Lord. We'd like to welcome the various visitors who are with us this morning. Hallelujah. Amen. We have Brother Asher from the Mutoko Assembly. He's around with work in town. So God bless you, Brother Asher. He's right at the back. Amen. Amen. I am aware of the wonderful works that you did back in Mutoko. Somehow it came to my attention, you and the family. God bless you. I really appreciate that. Amen. Most probably you didn't want me to know about it, but there's always a way of knowing good things. Amen. Praise God. So God bless you. Then we also have Sister Leslie and Sister Bianca with us. I'm happy to see you guys this morning. God bless you and amen. Welcome to the house of the Lord. May you enjoy the blessings of the Lord as you fellowship with us. Amen. Also want to inform you, as most of you or some of you may have heard by now, about the passing away of Brother Joshua Marire's sister. And I was there last evening for the funeral. And I understand that she's being buried this afternoon. I think at about 1 o'clock, the burial will be taking place at Zorodo, as on your way to Chitungwiza. So that's where the burial will be taking place. I'm not so sure what time we will finish here, just in case. There could be a few of you that might want to rush over there that didn't have the chance of going over where the funeral was being held. So the burial will be at 1 o'clock this afternoon. So perhaps that will also depend on what time we get through. Amen. So just remember to pray for the family. They really would need your prayers. And the dad is so heartbroken, and was with him just a couple of minutes yesterday, and so heartbroken, so unexpected. But all the same, the Lord understands some of these things beyond what we may realize and beyond what we understand. I saw some of you believers there that came over for the funeral. Amen. So God bless you this morning. Praise the Lord. Amen. We also have here Brother Henry and Sister Divine. Brother Henry and Sister Divine, if you can come up in the front quickly. I spoke of you the other day, but your better half wasn't around. So if you can just come, sister, just come over. Amen. Just want to introduce this couple to you. Brother Henry and Sister Divine were engaged. When was it? Which month was that? August. Okay. Amen. I saw him make a little frown as though, like, am I forgetting? But anyway, this is Brother Henry over here. He fellowships with us here. And Sister Divine fellowships in a message church in Chivu. Somehow they got to meet and got to know each other. I think, if I'm not mistaken, the girl was at the Bindura University. And he's both Harare and a Bindura guy. So somehow things worked out for the two of them. So we are happy for them. Can we just give them a hand of applause? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. If I'm not mistaken, the wedding should be in December. Is that correct? Amen. So pray for them until that time. Amen. May the good Lord bless you. You may take your seat. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I'm informed here, Jonathan just gave me a note saying that attending the wedding is strictly by invitation. You know how these days things are, you know? It's strictly by invitation. Hallelujah. In other words, they are saying economical reasons. Amen. Praise the Lord. Then also we have a brother here with us, Brother Exon Dakama, if I got that right. Brother Exon Dakama, if you can just stand where you are. Amen. God bless you. What happened, Brother Keith over here bumped into the brother. He was trying to find a message church. He has just come in from Zambia. So he feel like Sunday is church day. So where can I find birds of a feather flock together? Hallelujah, hallelujah. So somehow in the providence of God, I don't know how it happened, but Brother Keith bumped into the brother, and only to discover that he's looking for a message church, and only to be told that you have arrived. Amen. Praise the Lord. So he's from the Hebron Tabernacle in Lusaka, Zambia, from Brother Kapisha, Pastor Kapisha. Amen. So, brother, we are happy to have you here with us. May the good Lord bless you. Whenever you return to Zambia, pass our greetings as a church to Pastor Kapisha. Amen. Tell him that we will never forget him. He was such a tremendous blessing, and we are still looking forward for another day and another time. Amen. God bless you. You may take your seat, brother. Hallelujah. Amen. Let us open our Bibles. Amen. Amen. Open our Bibles over to the book of Jeremiah. Hallelujah. Jeremiah 32. Our topic this morning is the seven sealed title deed. Hallelujah. The seven sealed title deed. Glory. Amen. We'll explain some of those little words just in a short while. Hallelujah. Jeremiah 32. Amen. Let me just read verse 1, then you can take your seat. Amen. I don't want to keep you standing for long. I know Jonathan sometimes is good at that. He does a very good job in delaying to get you to sit down. The other time I timed him, it was like 10 minutes before people could sit down. So let's read verse 1. 32 verse 1. It says, the word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord in the 10th year of Zedekiah, king of Judah, which was the 18th year of Nebuchadnezzar. You may be seated. Amen. May the Lord bless you. Hallelujah. And bless the reading of his word. Hallelujah. Amen. I want you to notice before we proceed with the other verses that in verse 1 we are told, the Bible says the word that came to Jeremiah. Hallelujah. Now, whose word was this? It wasn't the priest's word. It wasn't a man's word. It wasn't the king's word. Amen. It was the word of the Lord. Amen. And it's a great thing when the word of the Lord can come to us. And I believe that's what has happened in this day and age we are living in. The word of the Lord came not so much to Jeremiah, but to William Branham. Hallelujah. That's why, amen, he could stand before us. He could stand before people. He could stand before congregations. He could stand before individuals and say, thus saith the Lord. Because the word of the Lord came unto him. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. And sometimes he could see the word of the Lord in a vision. Hallelujah. And when he saw that vision, that was the word of the Lord coming to him for a certain situation. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. And we are also given the dates, like the year. You see, sometimes you might wonder, why do we say 1962 and 1963 and 1959? It's in the Bible because it says, in that year. Oh, blessed be his holy name. So don't take too much offense when we say 1962 and 1965, because that was the year when the word of the Lord came to William Branham. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Verse 2. Amen. Verse 2, he goes on to say, he says, for then the king of Babylon's army besieged Jerusalem. I want you to notice that the time that Jeremiah receives this word, amen, this word from God, the Bible gives us the circumstances in which that word came to Jeremiah. Amen. And one of those situations was, amen, the king of Babylon's army besieged Jerusalem. Think of this. Amen. The very time that the word is coming, look at the circumstances. Amen. Jerusalem was surrounded by the armies of Babylon. Jerusalem was enclosed by the armies of Babylon. They were encompassed by the armies of Babylon. But regardless of the condition, regardless of the circumstance, amen, the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah. Amen, because I don't believe that there is anything that man can do, there's anything that man can perform, anything that man can produce that will hinder the word of God from reaching the people of God. Amen. Amen. It doesn't matter. You might be garrisoned. You might be encompassed. You might have all kinds of things happening in your circumstances, but that will not prevent the word of God, amen, from reaching you. Praise God. Hallelujah. God can still speak to you. You can still hear his voice. You can still have fellowship with God. You can still have communion with God, regardless of what's taking place in the land. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. How many say, Lord, let me hear you no matter what surrounds me. Let me hear you talk to me. That's all that my heart desires today. Hallelujah. Let me hear your voice. Hallelujah. It's going to make me different. It's going to make me a different person when I can hear that voice. Hallelujah. It's going to do something to my being. Praise God. Oh, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Says, and Jeremiah the prophet was shut up in the court of the prison. Amen. Just imagine, even at such a time, hallelujah, besides what's happening around the city, Jeremiah himself is shut up. Hallelujah. Amen. Jeremiah himself, amen, is locked up. He's closed up. Hallelujah. The Bible says, in the court of the prison, which was in the king of Judah's house. Here is Jeremiah in prison. Here is Jeremiah in jail. But regardless of the circumstance, amen, God can still reach that man. Can we say, blessed be the name of the Lord? Hallelujah. Your circumstances don't matter to God. Amen. His voice can penetrate. Amen. His voice, amen, can break through those obstacles. Hallelujah. Somehow God has got a way of reaching you. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. What can we say about Joseph in the book of Genesis? When Joseph had been cast into prison, the Lord was with Joseph even in the prison. Praise God. The supernatural was with Joseph even in the prison. Praise God. What can we say about Moses? When Moses entered Egypt, hallelujah, when Moses entered Egypt, the very place of captivity, the very place of exile, the very place of bondage, the very place where they were slaves. But even then, the Bible says when Moses got into Egypt, the Lord spoke unto Moses. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Nothing, Egypt was not powerful enough to prevent God from speaking right on their soil, right on their ground. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God spake to Moses. Amen. I could get into something wonderful there, but let me bypass that. What shall we say about Daniel? Hallelujah. Daniel in the lion's den. Hallelujah. Even then, the angel of God was with Daniel. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Let me not dwell too much on this. What shall we say about Jesus? Hallelujah. Even when he was imprisoned, even when he was on the cross. Hallelujah. What shall we say about Peter in jail? What shall we say about Paul and Silas in jail? What shall we say about John on the island of Patmos for the word of God? Hallelujah. He said, I heard a voice. Amen. Hallelujah. Even though he was in exile, even though he had been excommunicated from human society, but even in those circumstances, John still heard the voice of God. Amen. What shall we say about William Branham when he preached 1962, the present stage of my ministry? He says, all men have forsaken me. But even in those circumstances, God was still speaking to William Branham. Hallelujah. Can we say praise the Lord? Yes. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let's come back over there. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It says, for Zedekiah, the king of Judah, had shut him up saying, hallelujah. Listen to the reason why he was put in jail by the king. Shame for the king to do such a thing, to put a prophet in prison. To try to put the word of God in jail. How could the king do such a thing? If ever there was a man that the king should have been listening to, it was the prophet Jeremiah. But you see, when people get into a backslidden condition, they don't want to hear much about the word of God. Hallelujah. They don't want to hear about the word. So because the king had gotten away from the commandments of God, the nation had gotten away from the commandments of God, now he says to Jeremiah, amen, wherefore dost thou prophesy? Hallelujah. Why are you prophesying and say, thus saith the Lord, behold, I will give this city into the hand of the king of Babylon, and he shall take it. Amen. Why are you pronouncing judgment upon us? Why are you telling us that there is a hell you can go to? Amen. Why are you telling us that there's going to be a destruction of the world? Why are you preaching the second coming of the Lord? Don't you know you make us nervous? Don't you know that you make us afraid? Brother, let me tell you something. If there's ever anything that is sweet music to the ear of a believer, is to know that Jesus Christ is coming back again in these end times. Praise God. That should not make you afraid. That should make you glad. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. And Zedekiah, king of Judah, shall not escape. This is the word of the Lord to Zedekiah. You shall not escape out of the hand of the Chaldeans. Hallelujah. But shall surely be delivered into the hand of the king of Babylon, and shall speak with him mouth to mouth. In other words, you are going to be right before the king. Hallelujah. And his eyes shall behold his eyes. Hallelujah. And he shall lead Zedekiah to Babylon, and there shall he be until I visit him, saith the Lord. Though you fight with the Chaldeans, you shall not prosper. Hallelujah. Amen. And Jeremiah said, hallelujah, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, here is another message for Jeremiah. Here is the word of the Lord for Jeremiah. Here is another message for Jeremiah. He says, behold, Hanamel, the son of Shalom, thine uncle shall come unto thee, saying, in other words, your cousin brother, hallelujah, the son, hallelujah, of your uncle, your cousin brother is going to come, hallelujah, saying, hallelujah, buy thee my field. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Here is Hanamel. Amen. A relative of Jeremiah. Hallelujah. Who understands the process of the law of redemption. Hallelujah. Hanamel understands what Moses said in the book of Leviticus, the 25th chapter, about the laws of redemption. Hallelujah. And amen. Praise God. There was something about this Hanamel that he was not going to allow, amen, this property to go to strangers. He wants to keep it within the family. Oh, glory be to the living God. Amen. He makes sure, praise God. You remember Naboth in the days of Ahab and the days of Jezebel. Amen. When Ahab wanted to take, amen, the field or the vineyard of Naboth. And Naboth said, how can I give my father's inheritance?
inheritance to you. Oh, bless her. Amen. We need people who stick to the inheritance. Praise God. We want people, amen, who hold to the inheritance. Praise God. Hallelujah. If God has blessed you, hold to that blessing. Lay hold on eternal life. Praise God. Hallelujah. Don't let it go for nothing. Amen. Hallelujah. Keep holding on. Hallelujah. You tell the angel, I will not let you go. Hallelujah. I will not let you go. I will persevere. I'm going to keep holding on. Praise God. Amen. And somehow Hannah Mill realized, amen, that this blessing, amen, this piece of ground or this property must not be alienated. Praise God. It must stay within the family. Hallelujah. It must stay amongst my people. Hallelujah. And he knew the laws of redemption. Hallelujah. He knew the rules of redemption. So he doesn't go to a stranger. He goes to a cousin brother. And I am thankful today in the bridge message, Brother Branham said, Jesus is my brother. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. He's my brother. So, brother, whatever you may have lose, go to Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. Tell him you are my redeemer. You are my kinsman. Come on. We need some more Hannah Mills here today. We need some more Hannah Mills here today. You know that Jesus is your father, is your mother, is your brother, is your sister, is your kinsman redeemer. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We need some more who are like Ruth. Go to Boaz. Praise God, hallelujah. Go to the kinsman redeemer. Hallelujah. And claim what is yours. Praise God. And tell him you are the one that can redeem. What a friend we have in Jesus. Our sins and griefs to bear. Precious Savior, still our refuge. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. So here comes Hannah Mill. Hallelujah. And what does he say to Jeremiah? Amen. You buy my field. You buy my field. Hallelujah. Amen. Isn't this something when you really get to think of it? That in a time of a crisis, when the land is being invaded, when the land is being run over by the Chaldeans, the land is being confiscated by the Chaldeans. Hallelujah. But that is the time that Hannah Mill decides to sell it. And as though Jeremiah is not clever enough to buy land in a time of a crisis, to buy land in a time of difficulty, to buy land, amen, in a time that the land is going to be destroyed. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. What's up with Jeremiah? Jeremiah, why don't you come next to yourself? What benefit are you going to have buying land, amen, that now is going to be burnt down, it's going to be destroyed, hallelujah, and then everybody's going to be vacating the place. Why buy it? But there was something about Jeremiah that he put his faith in God, knowing that one day, praise God, I'm going to come back to this place again. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Regardless, brother, don't look at your circumstances. Don't be controlled by your circumstances. No matter what the crisis is, trust God to secure your blessing. Trust God to secure your inheritance. You trust God. Put your faith in God. No matter how ridiculous things look, no matter how terrible things look, hallelujah. It could be a condition of sickness. It could be a condition of whatever it might be. It doesn't matter what the trials are. It doesn't matter what the hardships are. Put your faith in the living God and say, I know my Redeemer liveth. Praise be to the living God. We need faith, friends. We need faith. May the Lord help us this morning not to be controlled by circumstances. Hallelujah. But faith is the master of all circumstances. Hallelujah. Faith has got muscle. Faith has got hair on the chest. Praise be to the living God. Hallelujah. We need to step out in faith. Hallelujah. When you pray, believe you receive and you shall receive. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's not just about being religious, but it's about believing. Religion is plenty, but believing is very few. David's brothers had religion, but they never had faith. David had religion plus faith. Hallelujah. So he says, by my field, which is in Anathoth. Hallelujah. And like I was saying, hallelujah, Jeremiah actually is interested, regardless of the circumstances. Because Jeremiah is not looking at now, he's looking at the days after. He's not looking at the present, he's looking at the unseen. He's not looking at the present circumstance or the current circumstance. He's not short-sighted. He's not near-sighted. He's not narrow-minded. Hallelujah. Jeremiah is looking beyond the circumstance. He's looking beyond the situation. Brothers and sisters, can't we do the same thing? Hallelujah. If you start out believing, continue believing. Hallelujah. And as long as you believe, you are going to walk on top of water. Amen. Keep trusting God. Keep trusting the Lord. And if you trust God's word, God will release a power to sustain you on those waters where you are treading. Praise God. Don't worry about the contrary things. Don't worry about the controversies. Don't worry about the wind that's blowing or the waves that are high. Ignore the symptoms and keep moving on to the objective. Praise be to the Lord. There's a power that will uphold you. Praise God. He said, when you go through the fire, I'm going to be with you. When you pass through the waters, I'm going to be with you. God can suspend the laws of nature for you to succeed in your blessing. Hallelujah. Don't look at things the way they sit. Don't look at things the way they are. Amen. Look beyond that. Praise God. Amen. You know, in the wilderness, one thing that blocked the children of Israel was they were looking at the hindrances. They were looking at the walls. They were looking at the giants. They were looking at the chariots. But Joshua and Caleb said, even now, we are more than able. Praise. I don't care who's there. I don't care what's there. If God delight in us, he will bring us into the land. So buy it anyhow. Buy it anyhow. Come fire. Come destruction. Come chaos. I'm trusting my God that he's gonna make a way to preserve my inheritance. Hallelujah. Amen. I feel like singing the amen chorus. Do you love him? Do you believe him? He is the word of God. Amen. So the cousin brother comes along and says, hey, buddy, we're not told exactly what his circumstances were, whether he needed to pay off something, whether he needed extra money or whatever it was. We are just told that he comes. Amen. But according to the book of Leviticus, it says, if your brother becomes poor, poverty stricken, hallelujah, and he has no other source, hallelujah, this is the law. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Amen. Aren't you happy? You have a Jeremiah. You have a Jesus. You know, Jeremiah is known as the weeping prophet, which is a type of Jesus when it says he wept over the city. Hallelujah. He wept at the grave of Lazarus. He was reflecting the Jeremiah part. Lamentations of Jeremiah. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Jesus is our Jeremiah. But behold, a greater than Jeremiah is here. The Lord Jesus Christ himself. Can we say praise the Lord? Amen. And he gives him the reason according to the law. He says, buy my property. He says, for, hallelujah, or because. The reason being, on the grounds that you are the one that has the right, hallelujah, of redemption, hallelujah, to buy it. Amen. You have the right to buy it because you are a kinsman. You have the power to buy it. You have the authority to buy it. He's talking to a man who is in jail. You can't talk about buying and selling in prison, but my Bible does. He is approaching a prisoner and expecting a prisoner to have money. Expecting someone in jail to have money to buy land. And Jeremiah never shouted at him. Can't you see I'm in jail? Can't you see I'm in prison? Somehow, I don't know. The Bible doesn't tell us how this money was in prison with Jeremiah. But somehow, in the providence of the Lord, because God was going to be symbolizing something about the nation through Jeremiah. Can we say praise the Lord? You cannot buy property for a man in prison. You won't even be allowed to make that deal. Because he's a prisoner. He's confined to jail. He's under a sentence. Hallelujah. And naturally, you can't do this. Amen. But somehow, hallelujah. Let's go to the next verse. He says, so Hanamiel, mine uncle's son, came to me in the court of the prison according to the word of the Lord and said unto me, buy my field, I pray thee, that is in Anathoth, which is in the country of Benjamin, for the right of inheritance. Watch here, amen, the exchange of words, right of redemption, right of inheritance, right of redemption, right of inheritance, right of inheritance. Can we say praise God? Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. Jeremiah had the right to become the heir to Hanamiel. He had the right, hallelujah, to succeed on the property of Hanamiel according to the law of redemption. Can we say praise God? Hallelujah. Even our Jesus had the right, hallelujah, of redemption. He had the right of inheritance. Can we say praise the Lord? The right of inheritance is thine, and the redemption is thine. Buy it for thyself. Can we say praise God? In other words, Jeremiah, you have the title to inherit what is mine. Buy it for yourself, for yourself, for yourself, for yourself. Inherit this property. Come on, take it over, Jeremiah. Oh, bless. And I know someone who bought it for himself. Brother Branham said, Jesus, he did it for himself. He says, but he didn't keep it. He released it, because all that was in God was put in Jesus, and all that was in Jesus is put into the church. Jesus was the Father's heir, but the church is the heir of Jesus Christ. Can we say praise God? Glory to his name. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's go to Matthew 28. Amen. I just want you to get into the feeling of what we want to talk about. Even if I don't finish today, no sweat, no problem. No worries about that. Matthew 28 verse 18. This is the last commission to the church. The last commission to the church. Hallelujah. It says, Jesus or Jeremiah or the kinsman redeemer came and spoke unto them saying, all power in heaven. Friends, do you know that there's nothing that can move in heaven until Jesus allows it? Nothing can move in heaven until Jesus permits it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Remember when Satan in the book of Kings came into heaven before God, the devil could not go on his ace. He could not go by himself. He first had to report in heaven. Because all power in heaven is what allows or disallows, is what approves or disapproves. Nothing can happen in heaven until Jesus allows it. He is the boss of heaven. He's above powers. He's above principalities. He's above angels. He's above seraphims. He's above cherubims. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All power in heaven, praise God, is given to the Son, to the heir. Oh, glory be to the living God. Hallelujah. And what is His is yours. Praise be to the living God. Hallelujah. Can we say praise God? You feel good this morning. Amen. You feel you have a Jeremiah. You feel you have a kinsman redeemer. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. The right is yours. Amen. Hallelujah. The power is yours. Amen. The authority is yours. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. All power in heaven. All power in heaven. Hallelujah. No angel can go nowhere unless Jesus allows it. Oh, bless. 1963 on Sunset Mountain, seven angels came. Why? Because Jesus said, you go down there. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. And I also want to tell you, amen, I've got some good news for the Trinitarians, those that believe in three gods, God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost. That's idolatry. Praise be to God. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost is one person, not three persons. But in any case, listen, Trinitarians, hallelujah. If there is a Father in heaven besides Jesus, He is a powerless father, because all power in heaven is given to Him. Praise God. Some people say, but how can you say Jesus, He's the Father, He's in heaven? The word said so, because He said, no man has ascended to heaven except the Son of Man, which is in heaven. You mean Jesus was here and up there at the same time? This is the revelation of omnipresence, omnipotent, omniscient God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. As someone says in the Garden of Gethsemane, when he said, my Father, who was he talking to then? He was talking to the one in him. You tell me, where does the Father live? Because one time he said, the Father which is in me. Another place he says, the Father which is in heaven. Heaven was in Jesus. Because heaven consists of the Word. And when the Word became flesh, heaven became flesh in Jesus Christ. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. In the message, souls in prison now. At the end, Brother Branham said, hell is on the earth. He says, and if that be so, heaven is brought down here to us. So while we are here, heaven is here. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. So He has the power. He has the right. In heaven and on earth. You say, this happened in my life and that's happening in my life. He allowed it. Nothing can happen to you in this life unless God allows it to happen. You might be full of whys and whys and questions and all these things. Get rid of your questions. Realize that it's in His power. It's in His power. Times and seasons are in His power. God is in control of your circumstance. Hallelujah. Jeremiah, you have the right. Hallelujah, you have the power. Hallelujah, you have the authority. Blessed according to the law. Hallelujah, you are the one who has the ability to do this. Hallelujah. Can we say praise the Lord? Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Praise be to the living God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Jesus is the Father's heir. Jesus is God's heir. Yes. Hallelujah. And when we talk about Son of God, we are talking about heir of God. You can't be a son and not be an heir. And when He came into flesh, He was revealed as the heir. You remember the parable, the heir cometh. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Can we say praise God? Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. What shall we say in John chapter 5 verse 22? He says, hallelujah. He says, the Father judgeth no man because he has committed all judgment to the heir. And now the Son commits judgment to his fellow heirs. Because in this inheritance of his, he's not by himself. Paul calls it joint heir. Praise God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You have a part in what Jesus has. You have a share in what Jesus has. Can we say, blessed be the name of the Lord? Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Amen. I can imagine when Jeremiah's people finally came back after 70 years. Hallelujah. If there was anyone still living, they would say, where's my brother's inheritance? Hallelujah. I'm a joint heir with Jeremiah. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. John 13 verse 3, Jesus said, hallelujah, Jesus, knowing that all things had been put into his hands. Are you getting the idea? Oh, my, my, my. John 17, he says, the glory which you gave me, I give them. I'm just trying to help your faith today. You are not just a church goer. You are not just a church member. You are an heir. Hallelujah. You are in partnership with Jesus. Hallelujah. All that God was, say. redeemed by the blood of the Lamb, purchased by the Paul said, you are not your own. You are bought with a price. What price? The blood of Jesus is what purchased you. Those are our silver. So apart from paying the shekels, hallelujah, apart from paying the price, Jeremiah said, bring the book. This has got to be recorded. There must be a deed of sale. Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Because what is being called the evidence, that's the book. Hallelujah. That's the book. The prophet calls it, Jeremiah had to write in them book. I never said so. The prophet said that evidence was a book. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So Jeremiah says, apart from me having the land, I also need to have the book. It's just like when you buy a car. Hallelujah. Be careful that you get the book of that car. Because if you don't have the book of that car, someone from behind you can walk up and give you headaches. Can we say praise the Lord? Oh, but today, no more headaches for the bride. Because the bride has got the book. Praise be. The title deed is in us. Because he was told, John, eat the title deed. Friends, these things are so easy. I don't know for others, but for me, it's easy stuff. By the grace of God. Hallelujah. He said, I subscribed the evidence. Can we say praise God? 1962, Brother Branham preached a message titled, Confirmation and Evidence. Confirmation. Hallelujah. You know, everybody wants to be sure of something. Because you hear this language, can you confirm? Because nobody wants time wasted. Nobody wants energy wasted. So can you confirm the matter? Hallelujah. Can you prove it to me? Can you provide evidence? Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. Everywhere it's evidence. In court, if you don't have evidence, don't go. If you don't have evidence, don't go. Because they're not going to hear what you say. In this modern age, they will say, do you have a video? Do you have a clip? Do you have some form of evidence that is indisputable? Something that can finalize the situation, can conclude this whole thing. Can you prove it? Show us proof. Show us. Hallelujah. Everybody's talking about confirmation. Everybody's talking about, I need evidence. Hallelujah. Amen. You go into the supermarket, into the shop. Hallelujah. They will not allow you to walk out just like that. You are given a receipt. And upon that, there's a guard by the gate. If you don't have the receipt, you've got a lot of explaining to do. You can turn around and say, can you see that man by the till? He's the one that cashed in. You'll say, I don't care what he done cash in. I said that my job is not there. My job is to see your piece of paper. I want to see the piece of paper. Oh, for sure, devil, we're going to show you that piece of paper. We're going to show you that document. We're going to show you confirmation that I am healed. Praise God. Confirmation, I am delivered. Confirmation, I am a son of God. Because Brother Branham said, when that book comes back, the Lamb takes that book. He says, to make sons and daughters of God. It's high time somebody started telling the devil, you are wasting your time. Hallelujah. Because the great revelation has been made known in the opening of the seven seals. You tell them the revelation is here, devil. The title deed is here. 1965, he said, to her has been given the sevenfold mystery of the Bible. We got it, devil. We have it, devil. And we want you, Satan, to hear this. Brother, sister, my problem, your problem, is failing to operate the revelation. Failing to operate the title deed. With the title deed in your hand, you are the master of the situation. With the title deed in your hand, do you know that you might not even have to see the property? As long as the genuine title deed has been processed, you don't even have to see the car. Hallelujah. Even if the papers are processed, everything is in your name. You are happy, you are shouting, you are praising God, because you know you're just waiting for the manifestation. Hallelujah. Even if you don't feel like you are healed, even if you don't feel like you are saved, it's not about your feeling. Praise God. Jesus never said, did you feel it? He said, did you believe it? Amen, amen, amen. Somebody preach to me today. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. How many got the title deed here? You tell the devil, Satan, you are on the run now. I know what God has done for me. It's not only about Calvary, but it's also about the receipt. It's also about the paper. It's also about the book. Praise God. I know it was the blood, but now I'm also realizing it's the book also. Now we got blood plus book. Shekels plus book. Hallelujah. Amen, amen, amen. Somebody say praise the Lord. Somebody say hallelujah. Friends, we are not here to play message games. This thing is about making sons and daughters of God. Amen. It's about men and women realizing who you are. Amen. And what you are in this day and hour we are living in. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. So we've got the shackles and we've got the book. Hallelujah. Amen. We've got the blood and we have got the book. Hallelujah. Brother Branham said he died for us at Calvary, but hadn't yet claimed the book for us. He says, but that is to happen in the end time. In the last days, in the last church age. Hallelujah. And I like the place where he says, when the Lamb takes the book, hallelujah, he sends it down to earth, number one, and even goes even closer home to his seventh angel to reveal to his people. Amen. So 1963, the title deed was in William Branham as he stood there ministering the word of God. To reveal to his people. Now there is a transfer of deed from the prophet to the prophet's bride. And if we go to the abstract, we can see a list of the owners. Where, from the beginning. Because Brother Branham said abstract means searched all the way to the beginning. So we can even tell who was the original owner. Apart from Jehovah himself, among human beings, it was Adam. But then Adam lost the title deed. My, 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 my. But in the end time, he's coming back again. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. And with the coming of the book, there is a going back to the inheritance. Amen. Let's go to the scripture. Hallelujah. Are you happy? Are you praising the Lord? We should be the happiest bunch of people on the face of this earth. My. If there's ever anybody that should be showing the devil the door, is you. Hallelujah. Amen. You tell the devil, get off. Get off, Satan. Hallelujah. Get off. I'm connected to the kinsman. I'm a joint heir. I'm a partaker of what he has. His is mine. My beloved is mine, and I am his. He said, I subscribed the evidence. Hallelujah. Is that right? So whatever details were written out, like where, Anathoth, size, maybe 45 by 100 square meters. Hallelujah. My. All the details there. Signed Jeremiah. Amen. Because in your one day, praise God. Hallelujah. I'm not looking at the fire. I'm not looking at the destruction. I'm looking at a day of restoration. I'm looking at a day of a comeback. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He said, I subscribed the evidence. And whatever went, whatever details went with that evidence, it was all laid out there. Hallelujah. He says, and sealed it. You mean to tell me that the title deed got sealed? I heard someone, some man, some old preacher. Hallelujah. Tell me one time in a certain tape. Hallelujah. About the title deed sealed. I heard that. I heard it. Hallelujah. The title deed sealed. The evidence sealed. The book sealed. I heard it. Praise God. Hallelujah. As it happened with Jeremiah, the evidence sealed. I have heard also of the book sealed. The title deed sealed. Hallelujah. Sealed it and took witnesses. And weighed him the money in the balances. He says, so I took the evidence of the purchase. Amen. The book of the purchase. Hallelujah. Praise God. Both that which was sealed. Hallelujah. According to the law and custom. And that which was opened. Oh, am I hearing something here? The evidence which was sealed. The evidence which was sealed, then the evidence which was opened. Revelation chapter 5, Brother Branham said, here in chapter 5, it's sealed, closed and sealed. But he says, over in chapter 10, it's open. Oh, my. Hallelujah. Imagine this prophet is living out the end time message in types and shadows. Glory. He says, and I gave the evidence of the purchase unto Baruch, the son of Neriah, the son of Messiah, in the sight of Hanamel, mine uncle's son, in the presence of the witnesses that subscribed the book. Uh-huh. So now evidence is coming down to the book. The book. Hallelujah. Subscribed the book of the purchase before all the Jews that sat in the court of the prison. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I charged Baruch before them saying, hallelujah, thus said the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, take these evidences, this evidence of the purchase, both which is sealed. Hallelujah. And this evidence which is opened, hallelujah, put them in an earthen vessel. Hallelujah. Notice now, there is a sealed one. There is a time when you cannot know what's in there until it's opened. But then there is a time where the public can view because there's another part open. There was a period when it was not for public consumption. But then there's a period where it must be opened so that the public can now see. So the church can now see. Can we say praise the Lord? Hallelujah. So in some form, in the form of this document, in the form of this book, in the form of this evidence, in the form of these details, hallelujah, Jeremiah knew, even if I am not physically on the land, I've got a book that is representing what belongs to me. Hallelujah. I've got a book representing what belongs to me. Even if I go, even if my people go, no matter what takes place. But I know that after 70, we're going to come back and we're going to claim what belongs to us. We're going to say, I want my field back. I want my vineyard back. I want my property back. Can we say praise the Lord? Hallelujah. And under the message of Malachi 4, amen, the redeemed of the Lord are returning to Zion with joy, with singing. Can we say praise the Lord? Yeah, to save on time, let me do this. Let's go to verse 25. Verse 25. Praise the Lord. He says, and thou hast said unto me. Now Jeremiah is praying. Hallelujah. Jeremiah is praying. He says, thou hast said unto me, O Lord God, buy thee the field for money. So here now Jeremiah makes it clear that the transaction he done, it was because God told him to do it. And God would never ask his prophet to do something stupid. Hallelujah. God knew what he was doing. Regardless of the chaos and the destruction that was to take place and the desolations that were to happen, all the same, God said, do it. Hallelujah. Brother, you think when Jesus died on the cross, you think he didn't know yet that you would be born a sinner? Even after the price has been paid, you were born a sinner. None of you were born Christians. But why did he go ahead knowing that you are going to be still born a sinner, even though he paid the price for you to be redeemed? When you came to this world, you drank beer, you smoked cigarettes, you ran around, you did everything. You think Jesus didn't know that you are going to live a life that is desolate? He knew it. But at the same time, he knew you are going to be coming back. Praise be to the living God. You are going to be restored. You are coming back. Your future sinful life did not hinder him from paying the price. He paid the price anyhow. Even if you were to become the lowest drunkard, he knew it. But he said, I'm buying it anyhow. I am paying for it anyhow. They might live, their lives might be destroyed by demons. They could become a legion of devils. But all the same, I am paying the price because I know that one day they are going to have a practical experience of their redemption. I am sending the Holy Ghost to move into the neighborhood, to move into the community, to move into the society, that they may know the things that are freely given to us of God. Hallelujah. It's the word of the Lord. Buy it anyhow. I know you've prophesied. I know you've said there will be a desolation, but buy it anyhow. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. For the city is given into the hands of the Chaldeans. And yet the word says, buy it anyhow. Hallelujah. Then came the word of the Lord unto Jeremiah, saying, praise God. Let's go to verse 42.
Hallelujah. I'm sure by now the devil is fed up. But that's his own business, it's his own affair. For thus saith the Lord, like as I have brought all this great evil upon this people, so will I bring upon them all the good that I have promised them. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. You might have experienced all kinds of things. Hallelujah, but God is saying, I also will bring good upon you. Hallelujah, 43. And the fields shall be bought in this land. So all that Jeremiah was doing was representing the future that was going to take place. Hallelujah. Amen. You love the Lord. Amen. Whereof you say, it is desolate without man or beast. It is given into the hand of the Chaldeans. Hallelujah. Amen. But in the meantime, the title deed was there. The book was there. Waiting for the hour that they would come back and claim what belongs to them. Can we say praise the Lord? Let's go to Revelation chapter 5, the message, the tape. Revelation chapter 5, part 2. Can we say praise the Lord? Amen. God is good, isn't he? He's wonderful. Hallelujah. You know, in 25 of Leviticus, verse 23 to 25, the Lord said, the land shall not be sold forever. And he gives them the reason why. He says, because the land is mine. Hallelujah. It shall not be sold permanently. No matter who bought it, no matter who did what, they could not keep it permanently. It doesn't matter how much they paid. There was a temporal owner, a sub-owner, a squatter. It will not be sold forever. It will not be sold permanently. It will not be estranged permanently. It will not be in exile permanently. At some point, under certain conditions, where certain rights exist, the land had to come back. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I was just waiting for you guys to find the quote. Thanks. The prophet says here, the message, Revelation chapter 5, part 2, 61:06-18, paragraph 194. The prophet says, sorry, give me paragraph 159. I'll skip this one. This one is talking exactly what we were preaching about Jeremiah, just in case you want that for reference, because the prophet is saying, when Jeremiah wrote this book, is that right? So when Jeremiah said, I subscribed, Brother Branham said, wrote the book. Okay, let me skip that. You can take that if you want to study home. Let's go to chapter 5, part 2, paragraph 159. It's the same message, the same tape, paragraph 159. The seven sealed title deed. Can we say thank you, Lord? Seven sealed title deed. That's just an extract, direct extract from a quote. Hallelujah. The prophet says, now our kinsman is handed the seven sealed book. Are you following closely? What did Brother Branham say? Our kinsman is handed. Is that right? Is that scripture? He is handed. Here it is. It's given to him. Hey. Revelation chapter 1, verse 1. The revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave unto him. That's scripture.
We know Revelation 5 says that he came and took it. But Brother Branham says it was handed to him. Here you are, Boaz. I mean, here you are, Jedha. I mean, here you are, Jesus. God gave to him to do what? To show. Oh my. You know, sometimes you begin to understand why Brother Branham sometimes would make those exclamations. You know, you can call me a fanatic, call me a holy roller. You know, it's just something about it. Hallelujah. Handed the seven seal book of redemption. Are you listening now? This book is about what? Book of redemption. Book of redemption. Book of redemption. Hallelujah. Now, in the prophet's definition, what does the word redemption mean? According to Brother Branham's definition, to bring back that which got lost. Hallelujah. It is recovering what got lost. Is that right? So this book is about recovering. Hallelujah. Right, let me put it in 2 points. The book of redemption, this book discusses redemption. Point number one. You can't read it without seeing acts of redemption from the beginning to the end. It is a book concerning redemption. It is a book concerning acts of redemption. Now you might say, but brother, sometimes you sit before the word of the prophet and you pray and you say, Lord, what is he saying? And things just start to open. As you lay before the word, you lay before that prophet, you follow what he's saying. This just begins to strike and that begins to strike. It is a book of redemption. Point number one, the book itself discusses redemption. Check the Bible. The Bible is a book of redemption. It is a book, amen, which has got sections that you see things that got lost coming back. Is that right? Let me give you, for instance, Lot had a brother, nephew called, Abraham had a brother, nephew called Lot. Then the time came when Lot behaved foolishly by departing from Abraham. How can you leave the prophet and go? Anyway, long story short, Lot finally goes into Sodom. And then at some later date, war breaks out, the Bible says, between certain kings. A war begins to happen. And in the process of the war, Lot was captured. Amen. He got captured. Hallelujah. Amen. He became a captive. He became a prisoner. Glory. And those kings carried him away. And Brother Branham warns us right there. He says, be careful because, amen, legions of demon power can carry you away. Hallelujah. They can capture you and carry you away. Hallelujah. Amen. So when Lot got captured and Lot got carried away, Lot was taken into exile. Oh my. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Taken into exile. Can we say praise the Lord? Hallelujah. And while he's out there, hallelujah, he's been apprehended by these kings now. The Bible says there is a messenger who came to Abraham and said, your brother has been overtaken by demon power. Hallelujah. Your brother has been overtaken by the kings. Can we say praise the Lord? Can we say hallelujah? Amen. The Bible says then Abraham collected his men. Hallelujah. 318. Almost similar to Gideon's 300. Can we say praise the Lord? Hallelujah. He takes 318 men. The Bible says, born in his house. These men did not know the training of any other man. They were trained by Abraham to be warriors. And we are trained by William Branham to be warriors. We are trained by Elohim to be warriors. But what warriors? Born in the house. Not taken from somewhere. They were as good as his own children. And the Bible says he armed them. And they pursued the enemy. Hallelujah. Amen. And they got to the camp where Lot was. And they broke into the camp. Released Lot. Hallelujah. Recovered Lot and his possessions. And his children. Hallelujah. And Abraham said, we're getting out of here. Praise God. Redemption is a rescue operation. Can we say, praise God. Hallelujah. He rescued you. He rescued you. Wherever you were, he rescued. I was sinking in sin, but love lifted me. Praise God. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. A rescue operation. Hallelujah. And Abraham had to become involved in the battle. Hallelujah. He had to fight. Hallelujah. He had to fight in order for Lot to be set free. And in the Garden of Gethsemane, hallelujah, amen, he prevailed. Hallelujah, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, he produced a bleach that sends sin back to the greasy hands of Satan. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord. And the Bible comes to this point and said, Abraham brought Lot back. Redemption. The book is a book that discusses redemption. It is a book that expresses redemption. It is a book of redemption. We see things that had been lost being recovered again. Point number one. Number two, it is a book of redemption in the sense that when that book is available, you can claim back. You can claim back. Claim back your peace. Claim back your joy. You understand? Friends, these things should not be slogans. Message believers, it should be reality. You need to get the sense of what you believe. Not just coming here to occupy you with scriptures and quotes, but it's to get you to realize, amen, the reality of these things. That's one reason why God gave us the Holy Ghost, amen, and not the spirit of this world, but the spirit which is of God. That we may know the things that are freely given to us of God. And this knowledge is not just mental knowledge. It is experimental knowledge. Knowledge that will bring salvation into your life. Praise God. We'll come to a close in a short while. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Handed the seven sealed book of redemption from the original owner. Hallelujah. Amen. Who was the first owner? Who was the original owner? Hallelujah. The original owner. When, listen close, when we lost it, it doesn't say when Adam lost it as such, but it's collective. It is collective. When we lost it, many times we just look at Adam and blame Adam, but you're also involved. Adam was the head of the human race. He was representing the human race. And when he lost it, we lost it. Amen. We lost it as well. Hallelujah. Can we say praise the Lord? But I would like to say that when Jesus recovers the book, it's you recovering the book. He says, not for angels, not for himself, but for you. He says, redeem it back, not to the angels. He says, but for whom it was given, the human race. And Brother Branham told us that when the Lamb went to the throne to get the book, he said, the first thing that represented redemption, the Lamb came. Oh my, then I like where Brother Branham comes. He says, he did it for you, Charlie, and he did it for me. He says, what else could be waiting there but the bloody Lamb? Aren't you happy somebody did it for you? This time in recovery, in redeeming Jesus, the last Adam. The Bible said he was made a quickening spirit. The first Adam brought death, but the last Adam was made a quickening spirit. You know what quicken means? To make alive. That's what he came to do, to give you life. When you get Jesus, you are receiving a quickening spirit. When you receive the last Adam, you are receiving a quickening spirit. You were dead in sin and trespasses, but the last Adam is a living, quickening spirit. Hallelujah. There's no way you can have Jesus and remain dead. Oh, I have Jesus. You become a lively stone. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. We lost it. Can we say amen? We lost it. Hallelujah. Through Adam. He says that it went back. Hallelujah. We lost it. Brother Branham says it went back. Hallelujah. To the original owner. He says, but there's been a poacher on the land. Are you following this? The book got lost. The book went back to God. Then a poacher came in. Because he says, Adam doesn't have the book anymore. He doesn't have the authority anymore. He doesn't have the title deed anymore. He doesn't have the power anymore. So, Bride of Jesus, it's time to take our gospel guns out, hunt this poacher down. Hallelujah. Praise be to the living God. Hallelujah. What happened? A poacher came on the land. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Because Adam forfeited the book. Hallelujah. He lost the book. And when anything is forfeited, hallelujah, anything is forfeited according to law. It is losing by transgression. Losing by committing offense. So when Paul says, by one man's disobedience, in other words, we lost the book. By one man's offense, we lost the book. By one man's sin, we lost the book. Many were made sinners. He forfeited it. Hallelujah. But then what happened? He says, there's been a poacher on the land, a squatter, and that's Satan. Hallelujah. That's the devil. Hallelujah. And his demons, and his sin, and his evil. You were never meant to be devil-possessed to begin with. So why are you still devil-possessed? You were never meant to be demon-possessed. The book has come back. You can tell the devil, get off. Get off. Hallelujah. The great revelation is here. That was made known during the opening of the seals. My. The prophet said, he said he came over, that Satan, came over, he's a poacher. This earth don't belong to him. belongs to God. Hallelujah. So even though the devil came over onto the land, it's not his permanently. It's not his permanently. He's only here temporarily. Sooner or later, he's going to be dismissed. There'll come such a fire that will burn every devil, demon, Satan. Hallelujah. There will be a new earth with new owners. He says, how I could say something right now, but I better not. He says, now he's talking about seven seal book is the title deed. Are we hearing this? Is the title deed. What we've seen in Jeremiah 32 is now applying to us end time believers in the form of the seven seals. Hallelujah. Amen. That seven sealed book is the title deed. Can we say praise the Lord? Hallelujah. And for a moment, what is a title deed? It is a legal document. Hallelujah. It's not what you prepare yourself. Hallelujah. Or what your neighbor prepares. There has to be an official. Hallelujah. Someone who is authorized to process that document. You cannot pick every Dick, Tom, and Harry. Hallelujah. Amen. To process a title deed, it has to come through an office. It has to come through an official. Can we say praise God? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And our title deed, listen, was planned and written. Come on, wake up. Before the foundation of the world. Not in some theological school, some seminary or some cemetery. But it was written in glory itself before the foundation of the world. Hallelujah. Planned and written before the foundation of the world. And the good part of this is that your name was also there. He says the first name in that section is the Lamb's name. That's why it is called the Lamb's book. Because if you go to Genesis chapter 5, these are the generations of Adam. In other words, the names of Adam's children, but they start with Adam. The book of the generations. Hallelujah. Title deed. Let me close off. Title deed, a legal document stating evidence. Jeremiah 32. Hallelujah. It states evidence. It states proof. Especially in this day and age we are living in. When there's all kinds of cons and tricks and things that are going on. People are crying like nobody's business. This age is not an age to take things for granted. It's not a time to take things lightly. Somewhere along the way, it's going to give you headaches. Hallelujah. This is why there is so much. Let's put it in writing. Let's put it in writing. Let's take a video. Oh my. Hallelujah. Amen. It is stating evidence or proof of a right to an owner. It's a right to an owner. Do you know, even if, like I said at the beginning, even if the owner never sees the property yet, he don't know what it looked like, he has never walked the length or the breadth. And in the meantime, someone says, that guy,
Don't think anybody is going to be coming here, man. You go there and see one day. I don't think anyone will come here. Let's put a church. Let's put a garden. Let's put maize. You're going to regret that you put that maize. Because somewhere in the background, somewhere, there is someone who has got the paper. And that's what Brother Blessed said. Someone that is way back behind you can come and claim it. Hallelujah. When the maize is waist high, or starting to tussle, and the squatter is saying, ha, bumper. And the next thing here you see a Honda Fit, or a Mercedes, or a whatever, or a bicycle, or a motorbike coming up. And here comes a man with a paper sticking out of the back pocket. I hope I'm not making anybody nervous. And then he comes to the maize field and he hears, who there? Ah, Simon. Simon, come here. What's all this? You get the idea. Amen. Hallelujah. It shows a right to a property. Power to a property. Authority to a property. A privilege to a property. An entitlement. And remember, this guy with that piece of paper, this guy with that book, has got officers and officials behind. You just try to make noise there with this guy. Is that deeds office? Can I speak to Lovemore? Lovemore, I'm here. Put him on the phone. Okay. Hey, Mr. Monkey Hat. You see what I'm saying? It's a big issue. Yeah. Now I'm just trying to give you the picture of what it is now between you and Satan. After the seals have been opened, this is between you and the devil now. Devil! Before this happened sometime, that was another day. But this time, I heard the preacher say, to me has been given a title deed. I heard the preacher say, to me has been given the sevenfold mystery. Devil, do you know who you're talking to? And then the devil tries to say, ah, this, that. You say, hold on. Jeremiah 33 verse 3. Call unto me, and I will show. You said, who's there? Yeah, there's Monkey Hat here, Jesus. Monkey Hat is here. Monkey Hat sickness, Monkey Hat habits, Monkey Hat whatever. Put him on the phone. Hallelujah. Friends, it's high time we stepped out. The tools are here. The tools are here. The document is here. Oh, I wish I had time, friends. My, my. Hallelujah. So there's the number. Jeremiah 33 verse 3. Call. Hallelujah. And there's nothing like he's not picking. He's not picking. There's nothing like that. He's gonna pick it. He says, ask what you will in my name and I will perform it. And Jesus said, up until now, you have not asked in my name. Because previously people were just praying, Jehovah,
Lord. But Jesus saying, up to now, how come you're not using my name? Amen. Let's stand up. Amen. Let's just bow our head. Hallelujah. You are here, moving in this place. I worship you. I worship you. You are here, moving in this place. I worship you. I worship you. Oh, you are here, moving in this place. I worship you,
Lord. I worship you.
You are the way maker.
Oh, we say, Waymaker, miracle work, promise keep, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. Say he's a Waymaker, Waymaker, miracle work, he's the promise keep, light in the dark.
If you are here this afternoon, if you are here, you feel in your heart, God has moved in your heart. God has moved in your being. And the Holy Spirit has brought God's purpose to light in your life. You are saying, Lord, you are here to help me in the circumstances. Lord Jesus, help me to have that faith, that trust, that confidence. Lord, I have religion, but I don't have that substance. I don't seem to have that substance, that evidence, that faith. If you can just help me this afternoon, whatever it is, if I'm living as an alien, if I'm living as a stranger from the commonwealth of God, Lord, bring me back. Bring me back to eternal life. Bring me back to those spiritual qualities. I want to become a real son, a real daughter of the living God. Just forgive me of every sin. Let me find forgiveness of sins and redemption through your blood. Ephesians chapter 1. Forgive me, Lord, every sin, every trespass. Wash me in your precious blood. I stand here this afternoon. You are my kinsman redeemer. You can recover me from the hand of the enemy. In whatever form the enemy is in, you can recover me. I worship you.
You are here. You are mending every heart.
You just raise up your hand this afternoon.
I worship you.
Say, Lord, I stand here, Lord, at your mercy. I stand you here pleading your grace in my life. So I stand here today wanting to be free of every shackle. The devil could have ruined my life. The devil could have laid my life desolate. But you came.
Waymaker, miracle work, Even when I don't see it, you work. Even when I don't feel it, you work. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop. Say, even when I don't see it, you work. Even when I don't feel it, you work.
Glory to your name.
You never stop.
Just worship him, worship him.
You never stop working.
Praise him.
Say, you never stop.
Thank you, Lord.
Help us, Lord Jesus.
Oh, Lord.
Even when
give us a revelation of God.
Working.
Hallelujah.
You never stop.
Thank you, Jesus.
You never stop working. You never stop.
Oh, yes, Lord. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Promise, keep the light in the darkness. My God. That is who you are.
Break every chain. Break every chain. Break every chain.
To break every chain,
Lord.
To break every chain.
To break every chain.
So to break every chain. To break every chain,
Lord. Break every chain. Each and every hand that has been raised as a sign of surrender to you, O God, surrendering each and everything that is contrary to Jesus, each and everything that is contrary to the word, each and everything that is contrary to the Holy Spirit. Father, they are giving it up. They are surrendering today and saying, I take Jesus. I take this kinsman redeemer. I take you as my savior. I take you as my deliverer. Lord, may you break every chain. May you break every shackle. May you break every stocks. May you break every fetter and set the captives free and bring them back. Hallelujah. Beyond the fall, beyond the transgression, back into the age of innocence. From a child of disobedience to a child of innocence. Oh, thank you, Jesus. May the grace of God be upon each and everyone. May they live here a changed person. May they live here a changed being. Hallelujah. Oh, redeemed back to God for service, for worship, for consecration. Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, we thank you. Appreciate you so much. Bless us as we go our separate ways. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus. Lord, until you bring us back again for the Wednesday night service, Wednesday night prayer meeting, Lord, we look forward to a tremendous blessing and an outpouring, as always, to have that experience in the Holy Ghost. We thank you and appreciate you in Jesus' name. Amen. The Lord bless you. Amen. We meet again Wednesday evening for our prayer service. I hear the chains falling. Can you sing that for us?
I hear the chains falling. The chains falling. Oh, I hear the chains, they are falling. I hear the chains falling. Amen. Before we dismiss, there's an announcement here. All the young people, ages 19 to 35, single. If you're 19 to 35 and you're not married, can you submit your name to Brother Andrew? Brother Andrew, can you stand up so that people can see? You can submit your names to Brother Andrew after service, 19 to 35 and not married. Then those wanting to get baptized, you can submit your names to Brother Peter. He's just right at the back by the door there. All those who want to be baptized, you can just submit your names to Brother Peter. 19 to 35 and not married, you see Brother Andrew. God bless you. Amen. As we dismiss.
The chains falling.
God bless you, saints. God bless you, saints. We thank God for the service. There is a brother who's looking for car keys, for his car keys. There's a brother who has lost some car keys. May you kindly check around you, where you are sitting, if there is some car keys somewhere. God bless you. Thank you.
The chains falling. Oh, I hear the chains falling. I hear.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Lord. In the name of the Lord, and there is power in the name of Jesus, and there is power in the name, in the name, in the name. It delivers our soul, brings us to Christ, heals all the sin, rights all the wrong. It's the power in the name. I hear the church, I hear the church, I hear the church falling.